I would like you to look at this image for a few seconds. Okay, now I want you to try to imagine how this picture sounds like. I know this is a weird request, but it is not as unusual as you might think. In fact, the idea of being able to listen to visual information has been around for centuries in some capacity. Aristotle, for example, entertained the idea of combined senses way before we learned about synesthesia, the exceptional neurological phenomenon of perceiving events through non-normative senses, like hearing, colors. Aristotle thought that the only way for us to recognize qualities from different sensory stimuli, like, for example, differentiating red from loud, will come from one special additional sense that will combine all the others. That's an interesting idea, of course, but again, very few people will be able to listen to the picture that I just showed you, or any other for that matter. Understandably, the notion of a one-to-one relationship between images and sound for the rest of us is way too appealing to be abandoned. Besides, we have technology, right? In 1735, Louis Bertrand Castel created the ocular harpsichord, a conceptual invention that will use the seven notes of the Western natural scale, do, re, mi, etc., to play the seven colors of the visible spectrum, which are the same colors that you see in the rainbow. The ocular harpsichord was never actually built, but this speculative instrument was certainly a sign of the perceived direct relationship between note and color that we keep trying to model until this day. Fast forward a couple of centuries, and the popularization of computers brought new hope to artists involved in the visual music movement. The possibility of creating art using this one-to-one relationship between images and sound seemed closer than ever. In 1994, computer animation pioneer John Whitney called to the prospect of this relationship a fine art for eye and ear. Unfortunately, John Whitney died a year later without being able to witness what this new form of mixed media will actually look and sound like. And by 2005, composer and video artist Bill Alves had already stated that attempts to create a direct mapping of color relationships to the immediacy of musical consonants and dissonance have largely failed. But something else was happening in 2005. Early manifestations of a technique now known as databending started to emerge in several corners of the internet. People started experimenting by opening computer files in software editors not intended for those files. Most of the early examples of this technique consisted of photographs opened and modified in text editors, like Word, just to be opened back as images. The process will introduce glitches to the normal image, creating a new digitally native decadent aesthetic. The technique itself became a staple of a new genre known as glitch art. A genre based on introducing not errors, but unexpected events with relatively unpredictable outcomes. Databending revealed to glitch artists everywhere the synesthetic nature of computers. You see, databending is only possible because computers use the exact same language to produce images, text, and sound. John Whitney was right, after all. Computers held the secret to this fine art for eye and ear because they are, in essence, synesthetes due to the fact that digital data is multimodal. However, using the same data to create images and sound comes at a price, or rather two. First, It requires the glitch to be tamed. It requires the creator to deprive these creative bursts from their unexpected nature by making them purposeful and predictable. Second, it requires us to break our dependency on canonical sound and visual art. It requires us to get away with the legacy of the harpsichord and its seven colors and seven notes model, and to understand that a fine art for eye and ear might be as unconventional as glitch art. Remember this picture? This image was not drawn. It was generated using a synthesizer and principles learned from years of experimentation with databending. The result was then recorded and saved as an image file. And now I want to play a few seconds of this image for you.